After the experience at Hefner Runestone Park, I began to look for other places to go that might have signs or possible activity. It was several months later. In August, I went to a wildlife refuge on the Arkansas River. This was one of the first photos or series of photos I took of the elementals. That's really how this started for me. I've always been aware of them. I'm an energy worker, and you get pictures of energies sometimes if you take pictures. I saw pictures someone had taken of real gnomes beside some garden gnomes in the town where I used to live. I was aware they were around me, and I wanted to see them. It was after moving to Oklahoma I began to take pictures of them. People say they show themselves to you. I didn't realize that Sasquatch are usually near the elementals because I didn't see them at first. It was only after reviewing the photos later. I had also been watching another channel out of Long Island. It was very eye-opening to the possibility that these beings could be in suburban areas, our parks, outdoor recreational places, protected lands like preserves and refuges. While this concept was not novel, it seemed like a real possibility to me given what I knew about this area. There are many stories of sightings and encounters here. Most of these are not in the most remote of places. They're typically in places near human activity. Most of the sightings I heard of in Oklahoma happened along the lakes, rivers, and streams. It was here in the river bottoms I was told I would find them. Right after going to the wildlife refuge, I was drawn to the park. I discovered on a previous visit, after a rainstorm, there were miles of nature trails, and I planned to return. These are some of my first photos from last summer, and here is my story. The first day I visited, I traveled along the south side of a wooded road. You can only drive so far, and some of the trails are paved and closed to traffic. There are other trails that run off to various places and parts of the park. There is a large wooded buffer area around the place as well. I started walking around the back part of the park first, exploring the less used areas. I eased myself into the park that day, impressed by what I had found. It seemed kind of magical and exactly what I had been looking for. I went back the next day. That was when I became convinced, or knew beyond the shadow of a doubt, that forest people were in my local park. That's what these photos I'm showing are from my first 2 days I went to the park. This was the south side. Not much back there, but a few things caught my eye. There was a thicket where the trees were not very tall, and there were little trails like game trails running into it. I found a few other little interesting things and thought maybe the little people could be living there. The other thing that drew my attention was I found a blind beside a paved walking trail. Again, this is an area no one uses. I shot a short video and I posted it called Bigfoot Blind in the Park. I've taken it down, but I'm including it here.
This is a spot right here off of one of the trails. I don't even know where I am. Back in the park near the airport. And you can see right there, over in there, I think is a seat. And if you look on this side,
near that area where I found that blind was a tree structure. It looked like some limbs laying up against a tree. I was drawn to that area. I felt like something was there in the trees. These pictures are what I think may be a Sasquatch in the trees. I went back in the fall and took more pictures of the same tree or trees, and it did not look the same. It had completely changed or collapsed. It looked smaller and not in use. What I noticed when I was there, the planes were landing at the airport. It was on the approachway for the airport. What it looked like to me was that blind was there so they could stand and watch the planes land. It was by a lake, and it had a natural buffer where people couldn't go, with creeks, thorns, prairie grass, and protected by ticks, chiggers, and mosquitoes. In fact, the insects were one of the biggest impediments to encroaching into their areas in the park. It's not easy, especially in the summer. I want to talk a little bit more about some of these photos. But also in the back area, I found what had appeared to be a fey mound. I got a little excited or lost back there, even though I was not far off trail. I felt like I was pixie led to some extent.
This, I believe, is a fairy mound.
Looking back on everything, I found a lot of interesting tree structures. The next day, I went back to explore a different section. This is what I called the Spooky Woods. At that point, it was known as the Spooky Woods. That first day I went back there, it did seem spooky. It was very quiet. One thing I noticed in these places are actually not very popular in the summer because of the heat and the insects. It tends to keep people out, and they're more popular in the fall and winter. I went through 100 spider webs that day, so I know no one had been back there. I was covered in them. At one point, I remember the spider webs and horseflies sent me running and flailing my arms down the trail, trying to get them off of me. It was worse than that. The chiggers will attack you if you go off trail, and they're impossible to see. It's an urban myth that they lay their eggs or stay attached in your skin, but their bites are really painful and don't heal easily. I felt as though that first day when I went back there that something was trying to keep me out or didn't want me back there. I don't think this was the case looking back now, but at the time that is how it felt. It's more like there was a protecting force, some kind of buffer to keep people out of there. It was very quiet. There's always a lot of energy in this one section. It feels different from the rest of the park. I'm not sure why that is. At the time, it felt creepy or spooky, but I think that was just my first impression, or not being used to it. Looking back now, what seemed spooky then, I'm not afraid to go there. Especially in this place, I don't think they would hurt me, or hurt anyone.
Very, very quiet right here. This is a very interesting and special area.
And on my left over here is the pond. Definitely the interaction seems to depend on who's back there. The times I've experienced it has been when no one else was back there. There were a couple of occasions where I had the most happen and I saw them was when there was actually nobody in the park that day and nobody in the woods except for myself. This is a man-made wetlands. There are a lot of creeks. They're natural, but they are incorporated into a system of waterways, reservoirs, ponds, streams, and wetlands. I think that's why they're there. Because there's a lot of water, it's a special place. It's a perfect place for them. They have a buffer, yet they can still come in and be close to people and possibly interact with them. I saw signs of tree structures, and I was walking further back about a mile. It was really quiet. It was very peaceful. It was eerily quiet that day in August. It seemed like the woods were absorbing all the sound. There were no birds chirping, no animal sounds, nothing. I remember I was looking at a big X, and I have a picture of that. I heard a tree limb snap, and there was no wind. Everything was green and lush. It was not dead or decayed or dried or anything like that, just out of the blue. There was a clear limb snap, and it was probably about 80 yards away from me. It shattered the quiet of the forest. I knew in that moment that it was to get my attention and that they were there. To say I was spooked at that point is not accurate. I felt a mix of excitement, joy, a little bit of nervous apprehension as well. That's what I came there for, and they were letting me know they were there. I walked further on the trail, deeper into the woods. It was very enclosed in places. It seemed spooky because you couldn't see around the next bend. You're enclosed in by these big elemental blinds on either side of you. This one place I passed was like a little knoll, and the trail went up, and there was a little cut down off to the side of it. There was a big tree trunk laying beside the trail, and it was covered over on the back side. It looked like something had made a shelter of some kind, where something could be right beside the trail. It also drops down two little hills away from the trail, down the embankment to the creek. And this was about 30 yards from where I was in the trail, just around the bend. I had stopped for a second to look at these blinds. It was so quiet, no one was there but me, or so I thought, and I heard shh, 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 not far from me on the trail. It was right off the trail in that little cut down the hill. It sounded like someone had taken three steps in the leaves. It didn't sound like a deer or any kind of animal. It sounded like footsteps and dry leaves. This is summer, so there are no dry leaves on the trail. This was in an area right off the trail where there was still thick leaves from last year. It just sounded like something got up by that down tree, took three steps, and was gone down the embankment. I froze at that point. I didn't know what to think. I wasn't really afraid per se, but again, you're just nervous because you know you're not alone. And you're thinking, well, it could be people, but you know there's no one else back there. You know that you're not alone. Nobody followed you in. This is not even on the trail, but right off of it. I had two things happen, two different places in the trail where I heard something. I know it was not natural and not an animal, so what could it have been? And I think they were just letting me know that they were there. At the time, each time it happened, I felt like it was a little nudge to keep moving. It had the effect of prodding me to keep walking along the trail. But I don't know that that was the case. I think it was just to let me know they were there. Because through all this time, everything that's happened, and it happened so quickly, it rapidly evolved over a few months' time. I worked to gain their trust, to get to know them a little better. It's never been frightening. And all of that, and if anything, it's been a very positive experience.
I found Bigfoot's living room. This place is weird.
I feel like I don't have anything to fear from this group in particular. I feel like there's a friendship there, and there's a gift exchange. They're amazing at the things I've seen them do. I wanted to share that with you and share these photos from last summer. I wanted to talk about some of these pictures. There was one that caught my eye. At the time, I didn't see the face on the tree. It actually looks like there's a face there. Like it's carved or an indentation, like it has an eye, a nose, a mouth. Maybe there is a limb that has been placed over it that looks like an arm. in that tree, what caught my eye was this little blue thing, which at the time I thought was a children's toy. I don't know what it is, honestly. It looks very odd. I'm thinking it's a children's toy or a couple of them at the time. It looks like there's another one with it that is black and has an arm around its neck, like it's hugging or holding it there. To me, it looks like a couple of elementals. If they're real or not in this photo, I don't know. I very much saw the blue thing. It caught my eye as a real item stuck in this tree, and that is why I took the photo. It was only after looking at it closer to see what it was that I noticed the face on the tree. Another thing that is odd, this is down a steep embankment and not easy to get to. I don't think I could have reached it or without falling in the creek to get a closer look. I think you'd have to be really tall to put it in there. What I see or intuitively feel about this picture is this was made by one of the Sasquatch there. It has his face on it. It's kind of like a thing they do, sort of an iconic representation or signature, if you will. I look at it as sort of an artistic thing. I'm sure there's more to it than that, but they do seem to be very creative in the things they make. This group in particular, I just see an artistic component to the things that they do. It's beautiful in a way. Some of the things are so unique, it's hard to explain what they are. I suppose a lot of it is a language, but it's always changing. And once you see something and try to go back, this tree with the face on it, this one thing in particular, I tried to find it again and couldn't. You see things and sometimes they change. Are they not there when you go back? Was it just meant for you to see? Did it exist at all? Was it in another realm? Were you witnessing these things because you were in their world? Maybe these things are not always there for everyone to see, but you were just fortunate enough to see it because you were there in the right place at the right time, or because they wanted you to see it. I think that's true for all of it, with how they operate.